Hello everyone, welcome to IEEE RAIT. In this video, we are going to show you how to make a tic-tac-toe game using Python language. We are going to go through the process of building it from complete scratch to all the way to the finish. The tic-tac-toe game is basically a game played by two players in which two players alternatively put X's and O's in compartments of a figure formed by two vertical lines crossing two horizontal lines, and each tries to get a row of three X's or three O's before the opponent does. First, let's make a Python file named tic-tac-toe. We need to create a dictionary named board. So what is a dictionary? It is a set of unordered data values. We need to put A1, A2, A3 values in first row, B1, B2, B3 in second row, and C1, C2, C3 in third row. Now, to initialize the player, we need to create a variable named player which is equal to 1. And to check the total number of moves, we need to create a variable named total moves which is equal to 0. First, we will make a reference board so that players can refer to the values from the board while playing. To make a reference board, we use the print statements to print the board. To check the status of the board, we will require a while loop. Now, print board A1 plus I plus board A2 plus I plus board A3. We have to repeat the same statement for the remaining two rows. Now, to check the total moves, we have to create an if condition so that if the total number of moves is 9, we need to break the statement. To end the game, we add the end check variable, that is end check equals to 0, so that when the player wins, the game will end. To take inputs from the player, we need to create a while loop and add an if condition. The code is as follows. And for vertical, if board A1 equals to X and board B1 equals to X and board C1 equals to X, print player 1 won. For diagonal, if board A1 equals to X and board B2 equals to X and board C3 equals to X, print player 1 won. The code is similar for player 2, only instead of player 1 we have to write player 2 and instead of X we have to write O. And similar to the other two columns, we have to replace A1, B1, C1 with A2, B2, C2 and A3, B3, C3 respectively. Now, to check the moves of the player, we need to create def check function and add a if condition for every winning move. First, for player 1. For horizontal, the if statement is if board A1 equals to X and board A2 equals to X and board A3 equals to X. Print player 1 won. And similar for other two rows, we have to replace A with B, C respectively. And similar to the other two columns, we have to replace A1, B1, C1 with A2, B2, C2 and A3, B3, C3 respectively. For diagonal, if board A1 equals to X and board B2 equals to X and board C3 equals to X, print player 1 won. And for vertical, if board A1 equals to X and board B1 equals to X and board C1 equals to X, print player 1 won. The code is similar for player 2, only instead of player 1 we have to write player 2 and instead of X we have to write O. Now, our coding is completed. Let's run the game. As we can see, the vertical condition is satisfied, therefore player 1 wins the game. Well, that's all we have for you today. If this video was helpful for you, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. Also, for more updates, hit the bell icon. Thanks for watching.